Leah, don't you love when it's like summertime and you're mm-hmm. looking out at the water mm-hmm. and you see everyone on the boats mm-hmm. and you just want to like live through them?
Yeah, you want to be on that boat. You're like, if I can swim that far.
Yes, exactly. And they'll but pull you can't, me up yeah. and we'll have a lot of fun together. So we all love boating season, whether you have a boat or not.
Uh-huh.
You mm-hmm. know, it's a blast. But we all know you got to be careful, right? Boats are nothing to mess around with. And so we got to sit down with the Coast Guard and the Coast Guard Auxiliary mm-hmm. out of Ocean City. If you haven't gotten your boat out yet from it being winterized or whatever you boat owners do, they have some tips for you that they want you to remember to keep you safe
yep.
and your family. So let's hear what they have to say.
So generally the first warm days of May, we start seeing obviously an uptick in boating traffic. What we generally see is people anxious to get out of winter hibernation and back out on the water, enjoying, you know, everything that Ocean City and the surrounding areas have to offer. Boating safety for us is just making sure you've maintained that boat after being set up all winter. And then anything you've taken off, put back on. Life jackets, kill switches, radio equipment, all that stuff needs to be checked and maintained before you get out and operate for the season. Big thing we see as we're out doing our law enforcement is life jackets, which mm-hmm. are a vital, vital life-saving piece of equipment that you have to have by law and also for safety. So making sure all those life jackets are back on, they're the right size and they're well maintained. Then obviously just maintenance, basic maintenance of your engines and whatnot. We see a lot of uptick in you know, loss of engine power and, you know, fuel filters clogged, things like that you know, simple maintenance can help defer and help keep you out of a bad situation.
Normally people having a good time, not paying attention to their, not being aware of their situation and situational awareness. And that's how you get in trouble. That's how you run into things that you're not paying attention while you're driving. It's just like driving a car. You have to be aware of your surroundings.
And to follow up with that, it's knowing the area. If you're new to Ocean City, if you're in town visiting, it's great. You do have the rental boats, things like that. And we love that you're out on the water, taking advantage of the area that we love. But we do ask that, you know, either get some information from the rental companies, or, you know, use charge, use, you know, navigation, whatever you can to make sure you're operating in a safe manner. Obey speed restrictions, only drive as fast as you feel comfortable. And just make sure that you're following good, basic, prudent seamanship. You know, if you gotta remember, boats don't have brakes like your car does. So making sure that you're operating in a safe manner. And then paramount to that is we're always here. If you do have a radio or cell phone, you can call 911 or our channel 16 on the Marine Band radio. Coast Guard will always answer. We're always staffed and ready to go. So, you know, as soon as you need us, feel free, please give us a call. We'll be there to help out in whatever way we can.
Well, you asked if they have life jackets on board. They said, sure, we got it. They're under there all wrapped up in a locked compartment. That's not readily available. We'd like to see them either wearing them or have them in a place that's extremely accessible if they need them at a moment's notice.
Just like driving your car, 0.08 is also the threshold. So while you can drink in boat, we ask that the operator, you know, abstain from drinking while you're out. You know, don't drink in boat. It's not a great idea. But if you do, be aware that you can be fined and or arrested for boating under the influence, just like you can for driving under the influence. So we ask that if you're operating, that, you know, just abstain until you get back to the dock. File a float plan. So what that means is let somebody know where you're going, when you plan to leave, when you plan to be back, an alternate contact number if you have one. And if you don't have anybody local, feel free to call us. Google, yeah, we're on Google. Look us up, call us. You can talk to us here at the station, and we can keep an ear out for you. And if you don't get back when you plan to, it gives us a place to start looking for you. As a Coast Guard member, we can't do what we do without the support of our auxiliarists. So what we do, what they do offer, they offer boating safety classes, which are amazing. They offer docks, free vessel inspections. And that'll actually, while not a get out of jail free card for us, if we do pull up to do a boarding on you and we see that vessel safety sticker that they give, it's gonna make the process a whole lot quicker, because we know and we trust them. We know that, hey, they're doing their due diligence. So we may say, hey, let us see a life jacket, and that'll be advice going through all the requirements. Just remember, folks, boat smart, boat safe. We're here 24/7. That's what you pay us to do, and we love doing our jobs, but not having to go out and get you is just as fun as having to go out and look for you.
And what I thought that was really cool about that, Leah, is when he said, like, you know, and if you have any questions, call them.
Yeah.
And my favorite thing I think he said the whole time is, tell someone if you're going out on your boat.
That really is one of the smartest things to do, just so that you have somebody on land that knows your itinerary.
Exactly. And that's why I really want to reiterate, if you're maybe going out on the boat solo or just a couple people and there's no one back on land to tell, call the Coast Guard. Hey, this isn't an emergency. Yep, we're going out. We should be back around 7, and they will keep an eye out for you. It's such a cool thing they do there.
It is.
Yeah, definitely. So, safe boating. We're going to have no accidents. Before I left, he told me, I hope this is the most boring summer for the Coast Guard. So, we hope that
Let's make that happen.
Yes, we want them to be bored all summer, you guys. So, you can start focusing on that, getting your boat ready, but don't do it yet. We have more coastlife.
That's right.
Coming your way.